So before starting the fourth video, I will recommend you to check the three videos that I made before with our special guest from RWTH Aachen, Germany. So the first video was about the admission requirements, then the next video was about the education system, and the third video was about the life in Germany. And then we move for the main thing, that main point of contention for everyone is like how much German is required for English taught courses, and is it at all required, and about the requirement of German in jobs and also in living, in the social life. We have discussed something about that in the life video, but we'll discuss in depth here, like a short.
Yes.
So that's why we have him.
Like before I came to Germany, like a lot of people I talked to, most of them said that German is not that important, but it is just like girls say that looks don't matter.
Okay.
But they matter. Similarly, German matters. Like, yeah, I have already said that to socialize, you need German. And like for jobs as well, you need German. Like,
so I think now all the people who have commented before and didn't trust me, at least they will believe it. And later I will give you more proof why you need German in Germany.
Yeah, like unlike Netherlands, like in Netherlands, you know, people speak English. But Germans, they don't really like to. Like if you're speaking to them in English, you are pulling them out of their comfort zone.
Okay.
And no one likes to be pulled out of their comfort zone. So if you really want to be friendly with them, better to get into their comfort zone.
Okay.
That's really important. Yes. So like when you're applying for jobs, like for part-time jobs or anything, most of them prefer to speak German. Mm. And anywhere you go to parties and all, if you're meeting German people, they speak German. Yes. And regarding levels like A1, B1, those are things for CV.
Okay.
Yes. Like if you are, if you have some course requirement of German level, you need B1 or B2. Like there is a German taught course.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, you need to show the level. But I know people who have B1 level certificate, but they can't speak German.
Okay. So they just have a certificate.
That doesn't make sense. They can write, they can understand, but they can't speak.
Okay.
And I know people with A1 level and they really speak good German. So important is speaking. Writing is not that important. Writing is only required only in cases when there is some guy who there is some job about editing and you have to write in German, editorial jobs.
Okay.
There are some student assistantships like that. There only you need writing and grammar. But even though you are not very good at grammar, if you speak enough to make a conversation, then that's enough. That will get you, like, make your way a lot of times at a lot of places.
Okay. Yes. And do you need German also for the English taught courses?
Yes, I said, like, you don't need it, but only if you don't want to do anything.
Okay.
After masters.
Yeah.
Like you will just pass the masters, but after that you have to do jobs, PhD. For that you need German.
And do you recommend anyone before coming to Germany to have some knowledge of German to certain level, or they can also do it from the scratch from here?
If you have time, please learn German and come, because here you won't get time. If you if you have some prior knowledge of German, it really helps. Yeah. And then you can practice your German language here.
Everyone, I think, because everyone speaks German.
It's the native language. This is the best place to practice your German.
And do they have any free German courses in the university for people who want to take?
Yes, that's something like they have a Sprachenzentrum.
Okay.
Okay. It's a speaking center of the university, but it's not free.
Okay.
Like there are some courses which have complementary German courses, like complementary German subjects.
Mm-hmm.
Like my course offers a complementary 3-credit German course. I can just learn half level of German, like A1.1 or B1.1, any half level. And some courses offer like 2 levels of complementary German. Okay. But if you don't have, then you have to pay like 360 euros for one level.
Okay, that's expensive, I would say.
Yeah. I think, yeah. But compared to India, in India also, in terms of rupees, it's almost the same.
Okay.
They also charge something like that. But yes, don't do like till B2 or B1 in India. Okay. Just have preliminary
maybe
knowledge.
Maybe A2 or
A1
or A2. Okay.
Then if you learn German here, you will learn better. Like India, in India, if you learn German, you will pick that Indian accent.
Yeah, that is obvious thing.
Like, yes, yes.
And the final thing is like, do you have like a requirement in jobs? I've heard, I don't know how far it is true, like a German CV and German interview, or it is for some companies?
Yes, in some companies. There are a lot of companies, they need German. Like,
okay.
They mention it specifically.
Also for the CV and also for the interview?
Yes.
Okay.
There are a lot of companies like that. You will find some companies.
I mean, I don't know, maybe with some people's help, you might be able to do the CV, but I think interview, unless you are really
yes,
a good
yes, like if you are doing a job in some university, most of them speak English,
mm-hmm.
especially in RWTH. But I don't know about TU Berlin and TU Munich. I have
okay.
heard not
Munich. I think is bit international. Munich and Frankfurt, whatever I have heard.
Yeah,
I don't know about other places. I have no idea. Like
yes, but like in companies, if they want German, like you have to speak. And yeah. Obviously, you will get companies who speak only English. You may do without German, but that will just make your life more difficult.
Mm, yeah. Like, so you are trying to fight against the.
Yeah. Instead of fighting, like.
Try to go with the
yeah,
flow, like.
Yes.
That, huh?
Better learn German, and you have more options. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Then stay tuned for the next video, which we will be doing on the part-time jobs and student assistantships.